In this fifth video of our series, we will look at using the practice of meditation to reduce stress. Can you relate to either of these people? Roberta is worried about herself and her family and has trouble sleeping. Almost all of us, at one point or another, have had some trouble getting to sleep or trouble getting back to sleep. Jack feels like he needs to relax, but has trouble doing so without a drink or maybe one too many drinks. Overuse of alcohol can certainly be a problem. Others smoke to relax, and smoking can cause a wide variety of problems. Additionally, smoking or vaping of any sort, including tobacco and marijuana, is an additional risk factor for complications from COVID-19. In the first case, Roberta had trouble sleeping. Meditation can help. Pertinent to the second person, Jack, meditation can help him and you reach a deeper state of relaxation with no drugs, alcohol, or smoking needed. Additionally, meditation can help you be more awake and more focused, particularly if you meditate sitting up during the day. And finally, perhaps most importantly, meditation is a time when you can practice skills that you can use later when you're in the midst of a busy, hectic day. Let's do a very easy 3-minute guided meditation now. Just find a comfortable place to sit or lie down. I'm going to have you close your eyes and focus on one diaphragmatic breath. You may want to put your hand on your abdomen if it's easier for you. Feel the full inhalation and the abdomen expanding, and the exhalation. One breath at a time. Again, abdomen expanding, and exhalation. During this exercise, your mind will wander, and that's fine. It's normal and part of the exercise, actually. When you find that your mind has wandered, don't give yourself a hard time. Just gently redirect it to the sensation of feeling one full in-breath and one full out-breath. Again, feeling the inhalation and the air going to the lungs, and exhalation. You may notice a body sensation. If you do, for now, just see if it's okay with yourself to feel whatever you're feeling. Let go of any thoughts about the body sensation. And again, not forever, for now, just be okay with however you're feeling. You can let any sound be a signal for you to go deeper into your relaxation. And again, focus on one full inhalation and one exhalation. Now, bring your attention to your feet and allow the muscles in your feet to soften and relax. Allow your lower legs to relax. Your thighs can get relaxed and heavy. If you have trouble relaxing a muscle group, that's fine. Just bring your attention there. Let your pelvis relax. Your back, shoulders, chest. Let your arms and hands get very heavy. Let your neck muscles relax. Relax your jaw, your face, even the little muscles between your eyes, let them relax. See if now you can get a sense of your whole relaxed body in the process of just taking one breath. Feeling the full inhalation and the exhalation. Again, the sense of your whole body as you focus on one inhalation and one exhalation. In a few moments, not quite yet, I'll ask you to open your eyes. When you do, you will feel more relaxed and more peaceful. Even with your eyes open, keep focusing on enjoying one breath at a time. And when you're ready, allow your eyes to open. Now, hopefully you do feel a little bit more relaxed now. Let's review some of the steps that you can use to meditate on your own. And again, you can also use a guided meditation that we'll talk about. You start by focusing on the sensations of one diaphragmatic breath at a time in this type of meditation. When your mind wanders, gently refocus on the breath. You can also use another object of your focus, such as sound, or you can use a repetitive phrase. Sometimes if I'm having a little trouble sleeping, I'll use the repetitive phrase, one. And that will remind me that the meditation is as simple as paying attention to just this one current breath. And then I just repeat that word again and again. With this meditation, we relax one body part at a time, starting with the feet and going up towards the head. And again, there are a variety of other ways to meditate and things to which you can focus. For instance, you could start by focusing on your breath, expand your awareness to your body, then the sensation of your body breathing, then sound, and then non-judgmentally focus on anything that arises in your awareness. Here are some free exercises, both websites and apps that you can use to find guided meditation. The first one is my website, stressremedy.com. And it has 14 free guided meditations, starting with a 3-minute one similar to the one we just did. The last meditation on stressremedy.com is a 20-minute meditation, helpful for people that are having trouble with insomnia or having trouble sleeping. And then again, there are 12 other meditations that are free for you. The UCLA Mindfulness Awareness Research Center has both a website and an app with free meditations. The UCSD Center for Mindfulness has free resources on their website. Another free app is Mindfulness Coach. There's a lot of other good apps like Headspace that may give you a free trial period, but a lot of those websites start charging you a monthly fee later. If you like any of the websites I mentioned, it's useful to add that site to the home screen of your smartphone. This shows how to do that with an iPhone. But there's ways to do it with any smartphone. And then you can easily get back to the website whenever you want to do a meditation. In general, it's helpful to make meditation a regular practice so that you can develop the skills and strengthen the neural connections that will help you in the midst of a busy day. If in the past you've been frustrated with meditation, a lot of times it's easier to do a guided meditation, at least in the beginning. One thing to help people with their sleep is sleep hygiene. Another is realizing that if you catastrophize about how you need to get to sleep, it's just going to make things get worse. If you start thinking that you're going to feel terrible or die from not getting enough sleep, let that thought go and think about tonight as a perfect time to meditate. As you meditate and just focus on one breath after another, you're more likely to fall back to sleep. Here are the common steps to improve what we call sleep hygiene. Avoid caffeine in the late afternoons and evenings. Avoid having meals right before bed. Keep the bedroom dark, comfortable, and quiet, and only for sleep, sex, and meditation. Doing work in your bed or in your bedroom can interfere with your ability to get to sleep. Have a regular bedtime routine in the evening and go to bed when you feel you're tired. If you worry a lot, you can try writing your concerns down. That way, you might not feel the need to rehearse your plans again and again in your mind. Don't try hard to go to sleep. Just think of it as an ideal time to meditate, as we discussed. If you're still having problems, contact your primary care provider because there are other things that could be causing your sleep interruption. When people think about meditation, they think that thoughts are bad guys. That couldn't be further from the truth. We would not be able to function in today's society if we didn't use our thoughts effectively. Even if you're daydreaming, that can be helpful at times. If you're having trouble writing a paper, sometimes instead of sitting in front of your computer, it's helpful to take a walk outside and just let your mind wander. That can be a time of creativity. However, thinking nonstop does not give us the opportunity to fully enjoy our lives. Additionally, we want to realize that just because we think something doesn't mean that it's true. We don't have to believe all our thoughts. It's totally different to think and believe, I can't stand anything, than to have that very same thought, but not believe it, and then just let it float by. In the same way, we don't want to resist our thoughts or get angry at ourselves for not having a clear mind. We all have silly thoughts that come and go. Practice your skill of not believing all those thoughts and not resisting them, and you'll be much less stressed. If you're in the midst of meditation, instead of being annoyed with yourself when your mind wanders, realize that the realization that your mind has wandered means that you are then mindful. Only then, when you realize that, do you have the choice to patiently refocus your attention. In fact, the more your mind wanders, the more you get practice in patiently refocusing your attention. That neural pathway will just get stronger and stronger. What are some common barriers that people have to being mindful? One is thinking, I'm overwhelmed. What's the first step to do when you think you're overwhelmed? It's to let go of that thought and do what's very next on your list with your full attention. The next thing on your list might be to ask someone for help. It might be to make a plan or a schedule, or it might be just getting to work on the very next task. When I was an intern, I might have to quickly stabilize one patient, go see another patient, then go back to the first, or sometimes I would need to call for help. How about when we start thinking, mindfulness is too hard? Well, let's prove right now that that's not true. On the count of three, I want you to take one diaphragmatic breath. One, two, three, inhale. Exhale. You could probably do that without a problem. If you start thinking mindfulness is too hard, that means you're just not using the right yardstick. Again, the right measurement is just the ability to focus on this one breath, one footstep, one bite of food, etc. Finally, there are times when we have tasks that we're going to do and we think to ourselves, I have to do it. We're really just lying to ourselves. When you start thinking, I have to work on my taxes, it's actually not true. Well, the consequence of not working on your taxes might be very detrimental, such as paying a large penalty or eventually going to jail. But in reality, and at least partly because of those consequences, you actually do want to work on your taxes. So telling yourself, I don't want to do something that you will do, just reduces the chance that you will be mindful. Additionally, I find for most of my tasks, there's more stress in having the task hang over my head than actually doing the task, especially if I focus on doing it one step at a time. A lot of times I actually enjoy it, even when I was dreading it. If you keep proving that to yourself time after time, you're less likely to procrastinate. In the next video in our series, we're going to learn how changing the way we think about things can help us cope and thrive. I'm Dr. Jay Winter. Click the link in the video description to watch the full video series. If you're watching on YouTube, don't forget to subscribe. Stay well, and thanks for watching.